Hi, it's Lata Brouwer, and you are now watching Violin Lounge TV, where you learn to improve your violin playing with joy. In this video, I'm going to explain to you how and why you should replace your tailpiece of your violin or viola. Well, the reason why you might want to replace your tailpiece is if it's broken, or if you want, for example, a tailpiece with integrated fine tuners. If you use a wooden tailpiece with loose fine tuners, like this one, this is made of wood. These are loose fine tuners that you can put on and off the tailpiece. If you put four fine tuners on it, it becomes very heavy and it doesn't influence the sound of your instrument that well. So if you want four fine tuners without the effect that it changes the sound of your instrument, you might consider a Wittner tailpiece, a Wittner Ultra with four integrated fine tuners. Okay, well, if you want to do that yourself, then first turn all the strings loose. You don't have to remove the strings all the way. I will explain you how you do this. Then you remove the ball from the fine tuners. If the bridge is already loose, then remove the bridge. Like that. A clever way to do this is to rub the strings around the neck of the violin. Put it through a loop like this, and then, well, sometimes it remains in that position. Then you can remove the tailpiece. Maybe you want to clean it a little. Don't go carrying around this violin like this, because the pressure is now off the soundboard, so the sound posts can fall if you're not careful. So be very careful with this. But you can very carefully maybe clean the violin at this point, because you might be able to clean it the corners that you normally can't clean it. Well, then you get the tailpiece. Look, this is the difference between the two tailpieces. This is a lot heavier. And also the fine tuners stick out, which mutes the violin. Okay, then you turn the fine tuners all the way up, so you can use them for a while. If you leave them turned in, then you have to make them loose and then later. This is the loop that comes along with the tailpiece. You have here some copper, golden kind of thingies. Turn one of them off like this. Put it through the tailpiece. Here are two little holes. Put it on this side through, and then on the other side. Well, you might put this one again on, and then we're going to measure how long it must be. Because in this way, you can make this little loop longer and shorter most of the time, but I'll show you what's the exact length. Put it around this, and then squeeze them together, because they will be together when you put it on. And then you see, the tailpiece always must be loose from the soundboard. So the tailpiece shouldn't be that close that it touches the soundboard. But in this case, it's a bit too far away. So I will adjust that. Okay. I will make this little loop a little bit shorter for that purpose. And then let's measure it again. And I'm not pleased yet here. It's still too long. Okay, I think it's all right now. Yeah. Well, then you get a little cloth, because the tailpiece shouldn't damage the soundboard. Then you grab one of the strings. If you get someone to hold the strings for you, that can come in very handy. Get one of the strings,
make sure that they remain. So you put a ball through the fine tuner and make sure that the winding of the string around the peg remains kind of the same and remains neat, because that's good for your strings. Okay, then one by one you can do the strings back. Well, you see that this G string is not winded very neatly, so I will correct that. That the string rolls up in a way that it doesn't cross itself. Okay, then the A string. It can happen that the strings are mixed up a little with each other. Just put it back in the way they were. Here, for example, my E string is on the wrong side of the A string. So I'll have to make the A string a bit loose. Put the E string to the right side. And then take care that I roll it up in a good way. Okay, don't tighten too much. Make sure that you straighten the strings. Because if you tighten them too much, then the bridge doesn't fit under the strings. That's the next step. Take the bridge again. This bridge is a little bit, looks like somebody chewed on it, but it's just to use as an example. Okay. Put some tension on the strings. Make sure that the bridge is in the right place. The right place is between these two thingies in the F-holes, and that it's straight up. And that the strings okay. Well, now it's time to tune the violin a little bit, because there is of course some elasticity in the strings and of course in this little loop. At this point you can start tuning the strings. Do this not one string at a time all the way, but try to slowly put the tension equally on all the strings until you can tune them into the right tune. Then make sure the real measurement of if your loop of the tailpiece is correct is that this distance must be 1/6 of the vibrating string length, which is from the bridge right up to here. So if you measure this length, then divide it by 6, and that must be this length. You can imagine that if you have a tailpiece with for fine tuners, then this length is already certainly half a centimeter shorter, and that will definitely influence the sound, mainly muted, because you have less overtones when you do that. Well, now we have a violin that has a kind of optimal space from here to here, And you can tune it very easily, which is certainly with children. This is a very small violin. It's a children's violin. It's very useful because then the kids can tune their violin themselves. So I hope it's very useful to you. If you like this video, then like it and share it with your friends. If you'd like to receive more valuable and actionable information about violin playing, then please go to violinlounge.com and subscribe to receive my 2 free gifts for violinists worldwide. Thank you for watching Violin Lounge TV. Happy playing! Bye bye! Join me in the free workshop Weight versus Pressure, where I teach you to play the violin effortless with a beautiful tone. Go to www.violinlounge.com/free-workshop to get direct access to this workshop. I'm sure it will be worth it.